You're listening to the Chapter a Day Audio Bible. I'm John Stonge, and today we're in Zechariah chapter 14, and we'll be reading from the Christian Standard Bible. Look, a day belonging to the Lord is coming when the plunder taken from you will be divided in your presence. I will gather all the nations against Jerusalem for battle. The city will be captured, the houses looted, and the women raped. Half the city will go into exile, but the rest of the people will not be removed from the city. Then the Lord will go out to fight against those nations as he fights on a day of battle. On that day, his feet will stand on the Mount of Olives, which faces Jerusalem on the east. The Mount of Olives will be split in half from east to west, forming a huge valley, so that half the mountain will move to the north and half to the south. You will flee by mountain valley, for the valley of the mountains will extend to Azal. You will flee as you fled from the earthquake in the days of King Uzziah of Judah. Then the Lord my God will come, and all the holy ones with him. On that day there will be no light. The sunlight and moonlight will diminish. It will be a unique day known only to the Lord, without day or night, but there will be light at evening. On that day, living water will flow out from Jerusalem, half of it toward the eastern sea and the other half toward the western sea, in summer and winter alike. On that day, the Lord will become king over the whole earth, the Lord alone, and his name alone. All the land from Geba to Rimmon, south of Jerusalem, will be changed into a plain. But Jerusalem will be raised up and will remain on its site from the Benjamin Gate to the place of the first gate, to the corner gate, and from the tower of Hananel to the royal wine presses. People will live there, and never again will there be a curse of complete destruction. So Jerusalem will dwell in security. This will be the plague with which the Lord strikes all the people who have warred against Jerusalem. Their flesh will rot while they stand on their feet, their eyes will rot in their sockets, and their tongues will rot in their mouths. On that day, a great panic from the Lord will be among them, so that each will seize the hand of another, and the hand of one will rise against the other. Judah will also fight at Jerusalem, and the wealth of all the surrounding nations will be collected, gold, silver, and clothing in great abundance. The same plague as the previous one will strike the horses, mules, camels, donkeys, and all the animals that are in those camps. Then all the survivors from the nations that came against Jerusalem will go up year after year to worship the king, the Lord of armies, and to celebrate the festival of shelters. Should any of the families of the earth not go up to Jerusalem to worship the king, the Lord of armies, rain will not fall on them. And if the people of Egypt will not go up and enter, then rain will not fall on them. This will be the plague the Lord inflicts on the nations who do not go up to celebrate the festival of shelters. This will be the punishment of Egypt and all the nations that do not go up to celebrate the festival of shelters. On that day, the words, "Holy to the Lord," will be on the bells of the horses. The pots in the house of the Lord will be like the sprinkling basins before the altar. Every pot in Jerusalem and in Judah will be holy to the Lord of armies. All who sacrifice will come and use the pots to cook in. And on that day, there will no longer be a Canaanite in the house of the Lord of armies. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you for your word, and we thank you for the privilege of being able to look at it together today. And Lord, we thank you that in the midst of the details that you give to us regarding future events in this portion of Scripture, you also reveal to us that your Son, Jesus Christ, will be acknowledged as King over all the earth. And Lord, we recognize that that fact is prophesied in multiple places in Scripture, but we see it here in this passage as well, and our hearts are encouraged with that truth. We're grateful for the privilege to be part of your family. We're grateful for the privilege to be able to be part of the kingdom of your Son, Jesus Christ, through faith in Him. And we thank you, Lord, that you love us and that our futures are secure in your hands. Lord, we thank you for the privilege to be able to look at this passage of Scripture together today and be encouraged about the fact that you are sovereign and you are in control of our futures and that our hopes rest on you. We're grateful for it all. We love you, Lord, and we thank you for your presence with us today. We pray this all in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you again for listening to the Chapter a Day audio Bible. For more resources to help you in your walk with Christ, please visit us online at desirejesus.com.